So, we have already discussed about one humanistic psychologist. We shall discuss the other humanistic psychologists. And the humanistic psychologist is Rogers. We have already talked about Rogers. And in order to discuss about Rogers, firstly, we shall talk about the Rogers self theory, which is also known as person-centered theory. From the name itself, you can conclude something. So, Rogers self theory. And Rogers view on learning, because we teachers are very much concerned with the learning aspect. So Rogers views on learning. As you can see, a theory has been propounded by Rogers, and the name of the theory is self theory, which is also known as person-centered. The theory applies client-centered therapy and have three constructs as organism, self and self-actual. So in order to understand the personal theory or self-theory, we have to understand three constructs, which is basic of this concept, and that is organism, self and self-actual. So in order to understand the theory, firstly we have to understand these three constructs. Some of the students of biology may be understanding the meaning of organism. Organism refers to the biological beings. All human beings are organisms. Even an insect is also an organism. Am I right?
Yes, sir.
For him, organism refers to totality of experiences going on within the whole individual at a point of time. So within an organism, and of course we shall talk about the human being only, because we are discussing about the humanistic psychology. So human being as an organism, and if you will see yourself, you will come to know how many parts are there from which you as an organism are built. See, so organism. Organism refers to biological beings. It's clear to all of you. For him, organism. For him means, for Rogers, organism refers to totality of experiences going on within the whole individual at a point of time. And then self. Self, there are two subsystems of self. Self concept and ideal self. Rogers tells that there are two subsystems in the self itself, and the first one is self-concept. Self-concept means what you are thinking about yourself, who you are, which type of individual you are. So you are knowing yourself is self-concept, and ideal self. You may not be ideal self, but you have an ideal self in your mind. Suppose it may be Vivekananda, it may be some other personality, and it may be even a teacher, your father, and any person around you. So you have concept about yourself, that is your self concept and ideal self. Whom you do consider that he or she is a self, that is ideal image. The child becomes personalized and I and me appears, the self is being formed. When self is being formed, when an individual becomes personalized, and when he she becomes personalized, when the concept of I and me emerges. Yes, this is my book, this is your books. This is for me, not for others. So Rogers concludes that the child becomes personalized as soon as he or she starts to think in terms of I and me. Self is not a dimension of personality. There are so many, you can say physical, mental, emotional. So self is not a dimension like physical, emotional, mental and any other, but it incorporates the whole of it. Self is self. Self is complete. Self is not any dimension of the personality, but it's a complete personality. Self concepts are experiences that are perceived in awareness and is limited to only experiences with which we are aware. When we were discussing about the perception, we told about O and zero, then we were discussing about the forms. You can understand from there too. Whatsoever experience you have got. Bachcha jab janm leta hai, to bahut sari cheezon ka usko experience nahi hota hai. Ab pahli baar jab bachcha aag ko chhuta hai, tab experience karta hai, jalta hai, to usko brighter cheezon se thoda dar lagne lagta hai. So this is the indication. Self concept are experiences that are perceived in awareness and is limited to only experiences with which you are aware. Ideal self consists of experiences relating to what one thinks one ought to be and would like to be. Recently, I have told that you can follow someone like Vivekananda and any other, maybe your idea. That is reflected. Ideal self consists of experiences relating to what one thinks one ought to be and would like to be. Tum kya hona chaho? Tum kahan pahunchna chaho? Tum kisko follow karna chaho? And that is what your ideal self. So self concept and ideal self are very important concepts in Rogers' humanistic approach, and you have understood that there are two subsystems within the self as a concept, and what is those? Self concept and ideal self. Now, ideal self contains attributes or characteristics that the individual aspires to possess. No need to tell more and more. Tum kaisa hona chahte ho? Tumhari kahan pahunchna hai? क्या क्या अपने में तुम इंटरनाइज या एक्वायर करना चाहते? इट इज सिमिलर टू द कंसेप्ट ऑफ सुपर ईगो ऑफ प्राइड. बताया था ना, ईगो और सुपर ईगो. कोई देखे या नहीं देखे, मेरी आत्मा तो देख रही है ना. मैंने उदाहरण भी उस समय दिया. तो द सिमिलर टू सुपर ईगो ऑफ प्राइड, कहां कहां तक पहुंचना चाहते हैं? यदि नहीं भी पहुंच सके तो मैं वैसा होना चाहता. सेल्फ एंड ऑर्गेनिज्म आर रिलेटेड as self emerges out of the experiences of organism. Organism, you understand, the complete human being, complete individual. Self and organism are related. As self emerges out of the experiences of organism, whatso experiences human being and individual receives as an organism becomes the part of oneself. So self emerges out of the experiences of the organism. So self ka nirman kaise hota hai? Ki organism jo bhi experience gain karta hai, to usi se uska self ka
उदय होता है और उसी में से सेल का
सेल्फ एक्चुअलाइजेशन इज ए कॉमन कंसेप्ट शेयर्ड बाय मेनी ह्यूमनिस्टिक साइकोलॉजिस्ट। और ये मास्लो की थ्योरी का तो नाम ही सेल्फ एक्चुअलाइजेशन है, उसको मोटिवेशन की थ्योरी भी कहते हैं। यहां क्या है कि तीन जो इंपॉर्टेंट एस्पेक्ट है, कंस्ट्रक्ट है, उसमें नाम लिया सेल्फ एक्चुअलाइजेशन का। और इसीलिए कहा जा रहा है कि सेल्फ एक्चुअलाइजेशन इज ए कॉमन कंसेप्ट शेयर्ड बाय मेनी ह्यूमनिस्टिक साइकोलॉजिस्ट। और बुहलर पे भी आप ध्यान दीजिए, और यदि आप कॉम्स को भी याद करिए तो कहीं ना कहीं प्रकारांतर से ये सारे मनोवैज्ञानिक सेल्फ एक्चुअलाइजेशन की बात करते हैं। सो सेल्फ एक्चुअलाइजेशन इज ए कॉमन कंसेप्ट शेयर्ड बाय मेनी ह्यूमनिस्टिक साइकोलॉजिस्ट। बोथ स्टालवार्ट्स ऑफ ह्यूमनिस्टिक साइकोलॉजी रोजर्स एंड मास्लो फाइंड सेल्फ एक्चुअलाइजेशन एज द की ऑफ ह्यूमनिस्टिक थ्योरी। नथिंग न्यू टू एक्सप्लेन। रोजर्स बिलीव्स दैट एवरी इंडिविजुअल हैज अ टेंडेंसी टू एक्चुअलाइज हिज यूनिक पोटेंशियल एंड इट इज इनहेरेंट इन नेचर। टू गेट द पीक ऑफ योर पोटेंशियल, एवरी इंडिविजुअल हैज अ टेंडेंसी टू एक्चुअलाइज। एंड व्हाट इज एक्चुअलाइजेशन? टू एक्चुअलाइज योरसेल्फ, टू यूटिलाइज ऑल योर पोटेंशियल, टू गेट द पीक व्हिच यू डिजर्व। सेल्फ एक्चुअलाइजेशन इज डायनामिक एज इट ग्रेजुअली डेवलप्स। यू आर नॉट एक्चुअलाइज्ड इन वन डे, सो इट इज डायनामिक। एंड ऑफ कोर्स इट इज डायनामिक देन इट ग्रेजुअली डेवलप्स, दैट इज व्हाई इट इज डायनामिक। टू बेसिक नीड्स रिलेटेड टू सेल्फ एक्चुअलाइजेशन आर पॉजिटिव रिगार्ड्स ऑफ अदर्स एंड द सेल्फ रिगार्ड। Why we try to self-actualize ourselves? Sorry, self-actualize myself or oneself? Because regards of others. If I shall be more knowledgeable fellow, then I shall receive regard from others and the self regard. Yes. I am an important person. I am going to deliver a lecture. And I am a specialist in this particular field. So these two, that is positive regards of others and the self regards, are two basic needs that is related to self actualization as a concept. Rogers advocates to make teaching and learning more humanistic, personal and meaningful. You now to understand the meaning of humanistic, you know about the personal and meaningful. And if a piece of knowledge is important, meaningful, it means it is important for the person as well as related to the job, the tasks to be performed by the learner. So meaningful. Certain humanistic learning principles like desire to learn. This is for your educational implication part. So this is more important for writing the educational implication of humanistic learning approach. And of course, specifically about the educational implication of Rogers. Certain humanistic learning principles like desire to learn, meaningfulness of learning to a students, learning without treat, self-initiated learning are central to his educational thought and philosophy. So in the educational thought and philosophy of Rogers, these principles are important. And what are those? Desire to learn, meaningfulness of learning to students, learning without threat, self-initiated learning, etc. Since we have discussed these related learning principles separately, no need to explain it at this juncture. Let us see the next bullet, that is desire to learn. Human beings have a natural desire to learn. Humanistic learning advocates for freedom to satisfy curiosity, eagerness, and child-centered approach of learning. Child-centered learning approach is being advocated by almost all the humanistic psychologists. Here, under the head desire to learn, we can say every individual, when he see text work, have a tendency to learn, have a desire to learn. And that is why Rogers advocates that his or her curiosity, eagerness must be satisfied, and find it must be child-centric, keeping in view the child, his or her curiosity or his or eagerness should be taken care of. Meaningfulness of learning to a student. Whatsoever you are teaching as a concept to the learners, that must be meaningful to the learners. Learners learn more when they perceive learning act personally relevant and significant. Learning act be purposeful to learners. हमने कई बार दूसरे deliberation में भी कहा है, शायद इस के शुरू में भी हमने कहा, इस लेक्चर के दरमियान भी, मतलब इसके मतलब फर्स्ट पार्ट के दरमियान में, कि जब आपको शुरू में ही क्लास के कह दिया जाए कि ये जो टॉपिक डिस्कस हो रहा है ये आपके लिए बहुत इम्पोर्टेंट है, तो ये सारा उसी तरफ है कि जो लर्निंग मटेरियल आप स्टूडेंट को बताने जा रहे हैं, जो आप देना चाहते हैं, दैट must be relevant and significant to the learners, and learners must understand that this learning act is important for his or her. So meaningfulness of learning to a student. Whatsoever concept you are teaching, that must be meaningful to the learners. Learning without training, this is very important. Generally हम लोग क्या करते हैं, बच्चे को अपने कम टाइम की वजह से, अपने कम ज्ञान की वजह से बहुत धमकाते हैं, ये कह रहा नहीं, बिल्कुल बिल्कुल नहीं. लर्निंग विदाउट थ्रीट, और नाइदर एक्सटर्नल थ्रीट नॉर इंटरनल थ्रीट. लर्निंग टेक्स प्लेस इन ए बेटर मैनर इफ द लर्निंग एनवायरमेंट इज फ्री फ्रॉम थ्रीट. लर्निंग इज मोर व्हेन स्टूडेंट्स टेस्ट देयर एबिलिटीज, दे हैव अपॉर्चुनिटी टू टेस्ट देयर एबिलिटीज. You should provide opportunity to test himself or herself. Try new experiences. He is free to do whatever he or she is. और शुरू में हमने देखा भी था कि holistic learning approach में open class की बात करता था, याद है?
Yes, sir.
वो उसी तरफ. Try new experiences and learn through mistakes without the fear of criticism and failure. ये बहुत होता है. Criticism neither from the part of the teacher nor from the part of the colleagues नहीं होना चाहिए. humanistic classroom का और humanistic teaching के लिए ये जरूरी है कि the learning should be without threat, and threat must not be external and it must not be internal as well. डर नहीं हो कि मेरी शिकायत कर देगा, इसको नहीं आता है, इसकी तरफ इशारा करें. सेल्फ इनिशिएटेड लर्निंग, क्वाइट क्लियर. लर्निंग इज मोर सिग्निफिकेंट एंड ड्यूरेबल व्हेन इट इज सेल्फ इनिशिएटेड. व्हेन लर्नर्स आर इन्वॉल्व विथ फीलिंग्स एंड द माइंड, लर्निंग इज मोर पर्फेक्ट. माइंड फीलिंग्स इफेक्टिव डोमेन, इमोशनली अटैच टू द टास्क ऑफ लर्निंग एंड माइंड cognitive. So self-initiated learning
feelings and demand
is more permanent.
When learners learn and in the process of learning he or she is emotionally as well as cognitively involved, learning is more permanent.
Emotionally attached hai sikhne aur mentally bhi free.
Self initiated learning involves effective aspect besides cognitive, we have already told.
In the process of self initiated learning, not only cognitive aspect, rather effective aspect is important. And you all know through the Bloom's taxonomy of educational objectives that what is effective and what is cognitive.
Rogers, like other humanistic psychologists, consider a student's feeling and interaction among learners more important than methodology, curriculum planning and technology.
Clear hai ki Roger jis shikshan vidhi se hum padhate hain, jis tricks and techniques ka hum istemal karte hain, you can say pedagogy and even the content matter, curriculum planning kaise hum project karte hain, and technology machine ka istemal kiya ya fir different jo human factors se related bhi bahut sara technology ka part hai uske implication se bhi adhik mahatvapurna kya hai,
feelings and interaction among the learners.
Wahan yaad hoga hum logo ne shuru mein baat ki thi cooperative learning ki, usi taraf hi sara hai,
more important than methodology. So feelings and interaction among the learners, that is also an opportunity. Interaction is also an opportunity to interact, and that is also a type of feeling share karne. So curriculum planning, methodology, technology sabse adhik mahatvapurna hai feeling and interaction among the learners. Rogers considers certain methods of teaching.
Aur post mein dekhiye, shuru mein hum log kaha hai, शुरू में भी जब हम लोगों ने ह्यूमनिस्टिक लर्निंग अप्रोच की बात की तो बताया था कि एडवोकेट्स फॉर चाइल्ड सेंटर्ड मेथड्स ऑफ टीचिंग, यहां भी कहा
एंड इंस्ट्रक्शनल स्ट्रेटजीज हेल्प ह्यूमनिस्टिक लर्निंग. सो दिस इज ऑल क्लियर. हिज पर्सन सेंटर्ड अप्रोच, नाम उसका अप्रोच का नाम ही क्या है, सेल्फ लर्निंग और पर्सन सेंटर्ड. तो यहां कह रहा है हिज पर्सन सेंटर्ड अप्रोच is the reflection of his educational thought and
मतलब नाम ही ऐसा दिया है इससे अपने आप क्लियर हो रहा है कि वो क्या कहना चाह रहा है.
क्वालिटीज ऑफ इफेक्टिव टीचर,
किसको इफेक्टिव टीचर माना जाएगा,
जेन्यून एक्सेप्टिंग,
मतलब ज्यादा बनता नहीं हो, जो नहीं है उसको दिखाने की कोशिश नहीं करता,
एक्सेप्टिंग दूसरे के क्वेश्चन को भी, और जिसमें प्रवाह हो, इम्पैथेटिक हो, सिंपैथेटिक, दूसरे के बारे में सोचता हो, मतलब क्रिटिसाइज नहीं करता हो, जो बच्चा कहना चाहता है उसको समझने का प्रयास करता हो, उसी रूप में अपने रूप में नहीं.
तो इफ यू हैव टू बी ए इफेक्टिव टीचर एज पर रोजर्स, ही और सी मस्ट पोजेस दिस क्वालिटीज. एंड व्हाट आर दिस क्वालिटीज? जेन्यून, एक्सेप्टिंग and imperfect. So this is all about Rogers and his educational thought and philosophy. Thank you.